Hello Libra, welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea and I'm here to do your weekly tarot reading for the sign of Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. And it will be from the 29th of March to the 4th of April 2021. Let's get straight into your reading and pull your overarching oracle card for the week. So what do we have for Libra, please? Angels, spirits, guides, message for our lovely Librans. Okay, card is right out there. We have romance. Number 23, romance, it is a sacred power. Let it come to me this hour. Okay. Message, angels, for Libra, for the week. What do we have for Libra for the week, please? Message for our lovely Librans, thank you. I've got recovery, so it feels like recovery in romance. Either something within your relationship or something that's affected your relationship. But I love the image of the flower. Do you see the flower, the rose? Because it's beginning to flourish again. It's beginning to grow that energy. Thrive, open up. I love the energy. So I like these two cards together. Let's see what we get, Libra. I'm going to pull three cards and then I'll clarify, go deeper into the message. And it won't resonate with everybody, so just take what resonates with you. Okay, message for Libra, please. Angels, spirits, guides, message for Libra for the week, 29th of March to the 4th of April, 2021. What do we have for our lovely Librans? Thank you. Message for Libra. Two cards, Eight of Pentacles and the World. The Sun, the most positive card in the tarot deck, is the advice from Spirit. And we have the Fool. We've got some major arcana here. Wow. I mean, big major arcana. Okay. What do we have for Libra, please? Angels, spirits, guides, message for our lovely Librans. Can we clarify the cards on the table? 29th of March, please, to the 4th of April, 2021. What is the message for Libra, please? Message for Libra. Okay, Libra, so I have the Four of Swords reversed. Don't normally do reversals, but you know it is there, so let's do it. We have the Sun energy and the Lovers, card of Gemini. And the Fool is clarified with the Eight of Cups. I've got the Fool again. Wow, that is a dominating energy here. Wow, Libra. I'm going to clarify this. Let's clarify this Lover's card for Libra, please. Let's clarify this Lover's card for Libra. Yeah, we've got the Strength card. Okay. Okay, Libra, okay, Four of Swords reversed is exhaustion. Something has been exhausting. And it just feels like you've been putting your energy into something trying to get back on track. It feels in this situation, something has been exhausting. Yeah, this is this the Four of Swords. I mean, it can be a card of deep thought. Some of you giving some deep thought to a situation when it's reversed. But it feels like a situation has been exhausting, and it's to do with this relationship. You're exhausted, you're tired. Something has definitely been draining your energy, and there is some kind of need for closure. It's been hard work. And there's definitely an energy of the need to bring closure to a situation now, work towards some kind of closure, but it definitely feels like it hasn't been an easy journey. But, you know, the sense of accomplishment is coming your way. You know, this definite energy of what you've been, you know, working towards, it is going to complete. It has just been a challenging period, I'm feeling, for you. And could have been delays or things delaying you finding closure in a situation. But it definitely feels in this situation there is some kind of major completion happening here, or working towards some major completion. Now, it might well be that you're giving some thought to a situation because you're not sure what you want to put your energy and time into. It might well be for some of you that you haven't quite made up your mind. It definitely feels that you're tired, you're exhausted. You know you have to make some kind of decision choice to do with a relationship in order to herald a period of recovery. But you just haven't quite made up your mind in which way you want to go. And this reading won't be for everybody. You know, because the Lover's card is a card, it can be a card of choice. It was always called the Choice card originally, and then it was changed to the Lover's card. It can be to do with choices, and in this case it feels to do with matters of the heart. The Lovers can be a harmonious relationship, but this is needing the strength from within and the courage to face some kind of fear or adversity and overcome it. So I have to be strong and face this and make this choice and decision for myself in order to release and feel good and step into my light once more. The Sun is a card of happiness, joy, also regeneration and restoration. This is about stepping into your power, stepping into your light, but also bringing light to a situation that I feel there's been delays for whatever reason, and either you're putting something off or the other person in the relationship in terms of bringing something to a completion or making a final choice or a decision to do with the relationship. Or it feels in this situation, you know, you've just been waiting to find the answer on which way to move forward. But either way, it definitely feels for some of you, you're aware, you're getting the answer. You're very clear in terms of how you want to move forward. There is just the strength to do that, the strength, the power, the courage to see something through. Yeah. I've got two Fool cards. The Sun energy, the Fool, two Fools. These are liberation energies. So like I said, this won't be for everybody. But sometimes this Eight of Cups can be about saying goodbye. Moving on from disappointment as well. So for some of you, this could be the strength to make some kind of choice or decision to move on from some kind of disappointment. Eight of Cups can be just a disappointing energy as well. So whatever resonates for you, Libra, but hey, listen, you know, look, the universe is saying, look, this is waiting for you. The near future outcome is a big, beautiful new beginning where you're releasing and you're holding your world in your hand and you're ready to carve out a new path for yourself. And feel pretty good. You know, this is a lovely, lovely energy, the Fool. It's a great card of optimism. It's a clean slate energy. It's a free spirit energy as well. But it is, I am so ready. I am so ready for this new beginning. A major new chapter for you. And it definitely feels for some of you that is opening up for you. I'm going to look. Yeah, you see, the card just knocked a little bit. And sometimes it does that, you know, for a reason. So we have the Six of Swords here. Yeah, detaching from choppy waters, moving towards calmer times. This is about somebody who is, they might have been dealing with, you might have been dealing with a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety. All of a sudden, as soon as you make that decision or choice, you feel calmer. You feel clearer about your direction in terms of where you're heading. And the worst is soon behind you. That is definitely the feeling, putting the worst behind you and moving towards better times ahead. But it's that new world energy that you're moving towards, the new direction, the new beginning. That this feeling of anticipation and hope for the future. It's a lovely, lovely energy, the Six of Swords. It's a card of transition. It's a card of direction. It's a card of detaching from the things that don't serve you anymore and moving towards the things that will. Can be a card of moving, relocating as well for some of you. But nevertheless, or life changes, life transitions, but nevertheless, something that has caused you stress, anxiety, worry, exhaustion, I was definitely feeling when I touched that card, you're finding the calm, you know? It's almost kind of like, there's an energy of, this can be the nervous system as well, and just calming that down. Nerves being on edge, stress, anxiety, worry, all of a sudden there is the release, the calm. I am moving forward and I am putting that difficult situation behind me. I just needed to face my fear, rise to the challenge, face the adversity and be strong about dealing with this, about making this decision for me. And as soon as you do, oh my goodness, the release. You feel restored. You feel stepping into your power. You are absolutely on the right path that you need to be on. There's a sense of positivity and new growth and success and empowerment that goes with that energy. So it feels very beautiful here. It just feels like there is, you want to recover, you want to, but it feels like there's some kind of difficult decision to make here and choice in love. And as soon as you do, the new chapter opens. Powerful, difficult reading, Libra, but powerful nevertheless. I'm going to pull you a final card. Final message for Libra, please. There is a new chapter coming your way, that's for sure. And this Eight of Cups can be you walking away from them or them walking away from you. But either way, there is definitely an energy of things are about to get a whole lot better. Yeah. Focus on the positive. That is the message there with the sun, because you're being guided every step of the way towards it. It's divine energy. Okay, final message for Libra, please. Final message for Libra, thank you. Yeah, we have Cat. Speak your truth. Have strength, faith and conviction in your voice. It has never been more needed. Wow. So we have the Cat. Speak your truth. Have strength, faith and conviction in your voice. It has never been more needed. Yeah. And I feel that's definitely to do with this strength energy. Having the strength. And again, the Gemini energy can be communication. It feels communication between two people here. The strength to communicate, you know, some kind of decision. So I hope you enjoyed the reading, Libra. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a wonderful week for you all and I will see you next time. Thank you.